With ArchiCAD 18, there are some major changes to consider when lighting your project. Light cone down, light cone up, wall light indirect, and wall light upwards have been removed and from now on can be fully replaced by the redesigned spotlight, and the new IES light that have all the necessary properties to be used with the new CineRender engine. When opening a project made with the previous version of ArchiCAD, ArchiCAD 18 in some cases will display a warning dialog. By clicking on Skip Migration, old light sources as library elements will be kept. Here's how our light sources will be rendered in this case. If you click on Migrate ArchiCAD Libraries, old library elements will be converted to matching light sources from the ArchiCAD 18 library. In this case, all lamps become spotlights after conversion and will render like this. It may look worse at first glance, but we can achieve a far better result converting them manually to IES lights. Photometric definitions of IES lights can be downloaded from websites of major light manufacturers. Simply put, these IES files contain the emission behavior of the light source. The downloaded IES files have to be added to the project using the Library Manager. Once the IES files are added to the project, they can be chosen by clicking on this arrow. As you can see, the Light Settings tab has been completely redesigned and offers a wide variety of adjustments, often illustrated with sample pictures of what a particular setting will result in. Feel free to experiment with these. In the case of IES light, however, the following settings will be sufficient in the majority of cases. Main intensity, color, and use intensity given in photometric file. Here are a few examples of the great results IES light can offer. And here's another set of lights where we used IES files that include data regarding the area shape. As you can see, the shape of the light source is visible in the render image. Please note this additional data that enables showing the area shape is rarely embedded in the IES file. Let's try one of the IES lights from the previous example. We will use the one on the right wall in a real-life project. We already have a few IES lights prepared with default settings, but first let's take a look at what the rendered image of the house looks like without IES lights. Now let's see how they contribute to the scene when turned on. The IES lights are a bit high, so we will have to lower them. But in general, we can say the use of IES lights have a great impact on realism when rendering a project.